fighting games, actually playing them, and not just the user interface design of them, they taught me a lot about user experience design. My name is Charmaine. I'm a software engineer currently at CDA. And today I'd like to show you 5 lessons that I've learned about UX. To prepare you for this, here's a crash course on fighting games. So in a fighting game, it's basically yourself going up against one other person or opponent. You can do things like move around, you can defend, you can attack using normal moves or using special moves. And your goal is to damage the opponent enough so that their health runs out, and then you get a knockout. That's how fighting games work. Now I'd like to show you how these types of games have taught me about user experience design. I started when I was quite young. So my cousin would come over and we'd play and play and play and play some more. At the time, she really liked this alien ninja character guy. One of her favorite things to do was whenever I'm up close and attacking with these really, really quick moves, she'd do this thing where her ninja character would flash suddenly and I get hit. Because I knew she liked doing that though, I learned to be careful whenever I'm up close. Similarly in design, know your users. Know as much as you can of their habits and the reasons why they do things so you can use it against them. Okay, to clarify, you use this kind of knowledge against fighting game opponents. But for us developers, well, we're meant to use this kind of knowledge for the good of our users. So no dirty tricks that we've probably fallen for on other sites. Do you guys see the issue here? Well, I didn't at the time, so I hit that big shiny button because, you know, I assumed it's meant to be confirm, unsubscribe, but no, I kept getting those emails that I didn't really care about. So like this, don't do that. But aside from these dark patterns, because hold up, I mean, we can know our users in a thing like fighting games, because at one time, you're only focusing on the one opponent. But what about an app with millions of users? This is a problem we face ourselves with NetBank CBA having over 7 million customers. But instead of worrying about each of those 7 million individuals, and also, instead of designing for just a generic everybody, our UX designers focus on these things that they like to call personas. A persona looks like just a single person, but Philippa here is really a synthesized bunch of different observations so that Philippa represents a group of similar users. We have an existing set of these for the target audience of the entire bank. Then for every new project we get, we discuss, well, which one or which ones of these should we focus on for this particular project. Say we wanted to build an app that helps parents teach their kids about money. Well, top left, Apana over there, she's a university student, she has no kids, so, well, she's out for this one. Josh is a father of 3 young children, so we'll keep him. Graham up there, he's a father of 2, but his kids are, well, no longer kids, they're adults. Supposedly, they don't have to be taught about money anymore, so he's out. Philippa is a single mother of a 12-year-old, so she's in. See, we narrow it down to Josh and Philippa for this Combank youth application. Then our whole team, well, we get to know them. But knowing those users, that's not enough. Just like how I knew that my cousin really liked abusing that annoying ninja flash move, that was only the first step. Because, okay, she did that all the time. But what can I do about it? After a number of games, too many games, I figured that if I stand a certain distance away from her, then I don't get hit by the flash. After that, she freezes for a bit while her character recovers. Then I could attack her with a move that is quick and able to reach her. So I had to know the rules of the game and what my options are to be able to use this knowledge of my cousin's habits. When designing, we had to do something similar. We have to know the constraints and then design with those in mind. They can be technological, cultural, time, or budget. Know the constraints that affect your designs. For example, our UX teams don't just complete their designs and then just chuck them over to us developers, like, here you go. They don't do that. Instead, they involve us here and there from really early on, especially when they're drafting up a design for a new component. They check in with us to see, well, can we build it? And also, can we build it within the agreed timelines? Aside from that, though, especially because of the massive size of our existing system, our UX designers face another constraint just because we don't want to end up with a mess like this. So you have one website, different pages, different font styles, button styles, forms. Our UX teams are constrained by design patterns already in use throughout our site. Through the use of things like high-level design guidelines and also design pattern documentation, our UX teams check their designs against these constraints as well. Over time, I started playing different fighting games. They came with different look and feel, different styles, different button combinations, and different ways to move. But through all that, there's one thing in common across all of these games, literally all of them. It's this bit at the top, showing health of each character and the time remaining. It's exactly the same in all of the games. So the health bars, when they run out, they don't both go left to right or right to left. No, always they go from the ends inwards, and then the timer is in the middle of that, which I never really noticed. I never paid attention until I started playing in tournaments. Because when you're down to your last game, say it's the final round, you and your opponents down to your last little bits of health, pressure is really, really high. At the time, you'll be thinking, wait, how much health do I have left? How much time? You can't waste time figuring all that out, so it's there in the one spot. Your health, opponent's health, and also time. This may seem simple, this design, but this layout design, it prevents players from having to split their focus at a crucial moment. This way, it takes into account the player's state of mind at that time. And while with fighting games, especially in tournaments, it's really fast-paced, it puts players in a state of mind where they expect that instant response. There may be other scenarios that come with quite different demands. For example, someone applying for a loan to buy this house. They'd be thinking, well, this is huge, because this is a lot of my money. This is my dream home. This is very, very important. We found that when users come in to apply for a home loan in just super simple, just a quick few clicks, they found that it was too easy. Too easy to the point where they weren't even sure if we did it right. So this was a process we actually had to slow down for the users. What we did was we split it up, broke it down, where the first page just goes step by step through an explanation of the whole application process. We added some images to break it up a bit. And when we ask for their information, it's in that same step by step, multiple panel type of style that we call blades. Doing it this way, it didn't just cut it up so that it's in more digestible pieces for the user. It also allowed us to slow the process down so that the user can feel like, yep, we're doing all the necessary steps, we're getting all the information we need so that we can process their application correctly. And we did all this just because of that specific context and state of mind. Learning fighting games involves learning your moves, from a button to do a normal kick, to a motion and a button for a special attack, to a more complicated motion for a more powerful special attack, it doesn't go that far, ignore that. But even this is hard. In fact, in one of the earlier games, the developers found it was way too hard, So they tried to make it easier by giving people a bit more time to hit that button after doing the directional motion. Time went on, and as gamers kept playing, they found that because of that button change, they could do something completely new. They could link attacks together that the opponent cannot escape. And that was the birth of combos. So really, combos were completely unintended. The gaming community discovered it, and they loved it. And now it's part of the fighting game genre. It's now a feature that's implemented and improved upon by all the fighting games to this very day. So this kind of thing, it shows how users will create their own experience out of what we build for them. And as what we can do as developers and as designers is to make sure that we learn about these things from real users as soon as we can, then perhaps embrace these unintended experiences or maybe enhance them. But you might find some unintended experiences that don't work out quite as well as that one. The important thing, though, is to find them out. So how our teams do this is, well, if you recall the personas from earlier, we have a database of customers that match each persona so that we can bring in people like Josh and people like Philippa to come in and try out to test out the Combank Youth app with their children. Based on how that goes, we can then identify things to improve or that we have to fix. Aside from these things, these usability tests, we have another data source. It's an app that we call the Combank Labs app. It's where we run various experiments. It allows users to trial either new features or changes to existing features. But most importantly, it's within their own context, and we can get very specific feedback about users' experience with particular features. In the end, at its core, fighting games are about imposing your will on your opponent. You have a number of options based on the rules of the game, and your goal really is to create situations that limit your opponent's options, and then they would do something rash, and then you punish them for it. As with UX design, we couldn't really design exactly what the user experiences. What we can do is take what we know to design the environment around it, design opportunities for the users to experience something. In the end, it might just be semantics and meanings of words, but looking at it this way helps to remind me that, well, if we take what we know of the user, their context, our own constraints, then every little part of something we build can become an opportunity, a way for us to enable the user's experience. So something as small as splitting an application up into multiple sections or flipping that health bar around so it goes down this way, they each have an impact and all of them add up. Hopefully, our designs and what we build taken together will guide the user through an awesome experience. With fighting games, you're doing exactly the same thing, but it's to facilitate as miserable as possible an experience for your opponent. Thank you.